Students, I am very happy to see you in this video lecture on the course group UIT PCIT Fine Art course name Mobile Communication, and I am Dee Rukmani, Assistant Professor in the Department of Information Technology, working in Bharat Institute of Higher Education and Research, going to deliver you the video lecture on the topic Mobile Network Layers. The unit 3, which is a mobile network layer under the mobile communication. The topics we are going to see under the mobile network layers are mobile IP, DHCP, ad hoc proactive protocols, DSDV, reactive routing protocols, DSR, AODV, hybrid routing, ZRP, multicast routing, ODMRP, vehicular ad hoc networks, which is a VANET, MANET versus VANET, and at last the security. So these are the topics we are going to see under the mobile network layer. Now we are going to see in detail about each one of the things. First, we are going to see about the what is mobile IP. Mobile IP is an Internet Engineering Task Force, which is IETF. Mobile IP is an Internet Engineering Task Force standard communication protocol, which enhances the existing internet protocol to accommodate the mobilities. The mobile IP, which is an Internet Engineering Task Force, which is IETF standard communication protocol, which enhances the existing IP to accommodate the mobilities. The mobile IP allows the mobile computers to stay connected to the internet regardless of their location, and without having to continually change their IP address. Every mobile user needs a continuous network connectivity irrespective of this physical location. The traditional IP does not support the user mobility. The user IP that was created by extending the IP, which enables the user to keep the same IP address while traveling to the different networks. The advantages of using the mobile IP. So it allows a fast, continuous, low-cost access to the corporate networks in the remote areas where there is no public telephone systems or the cellular coverages. It also supports a wide range of applications from an internet access and the email to e-commerce. Here, the users can be permanently connected to their internet provider, and they are charged only for the data packets that are sent and received. It can move from one type of medium to the another without losing the connectivity. So the disadvantage of mobile IP are a routing inefficiency problem, which is caused by the triangular routing formed by the home agent, correspondent agent, and the foreign agent. The home agent is abbreviated as HA. The correspondent host, which is abbreviated as CH, and the foreign agent. So here, the security risks are the most important problem facing the mobile IP. The problem in making the mobile IP, which coexists with the security features within the networks. So this is the disadvantage and the advantages of using mobile IP. Goals, assumptions, and requirements of mobile IP. So now we are going to see in detail about each one of the things of mobile IP. First, we are going to see about the goal of mobile IP. So with supporting the end system mobility while maintaining a scalability, efficiencies, and compatibility in all respects with the existing applications and the internet protocols. The requirements of mobile IP are compatibility, transparency, scalability, and efficiency. Next is security. So these are the requirements of mobile IP. First will be the compatibility. A new standard that cannot require the changes for applications or the network protocols already in use. The transparency, that is a mobility should remain invisible for many higher layer protocols and the applications. Scalability and efficiency. Introducing a new mechanism into the internet must not degrade the efficiency of the network. Security. All messages used to transmit the information to another node about the location of a mobile node must be authenticated to protect against a remote redirection attacks. So these are the requirements of mobile IP. The mobile IP entities and terminologies. Mobile node, which is MN. The device that moves from home network to foreign network, which is MN, mobile node. The node that can change the point of connection to the network without changing its IP address. The examples of mobile node are the laptops with antennas or the mobile phones. Home address, which is HA, the permanent address of the mobile node in its original network, that is an IP address of the mobile node. Next, the home network. Original network of the MN, that is a mobile node, was associated with the respect to its IP address before moving to the new network. No mobile IP support is needed within the home network. Home agent, which is HA. The system in the home network of the MN, which is typically a router, which provides several services for the mobile node. The tunnels IP datagrams to the COA, which maintains a location registry of MA, MA, which means a mobile edge, home agent, implementations of HA, which is an home agent. So which is implemented on a router that is responsible for the home network. So it is also implemented on an arbitrary node in the subnet. The disadvantage is which will be having a double crossing of the router. A packet for the MN comes in via the router. The home agent sends it to the tunnel, which again crosses the router once. So the home agent could be again on the router, but this time only acting as a manager for MNs belonging to the virtual home network. Foreign agent FA. The system in the current foreign network of the MN, which is typically a router, it can have a COA. COA means which is a care of address. The system in the current foreign network of MN, typically a router, it can have COA, which also provides several services to MN during its visits to the foreign network, which forwards the tunnel datagrams to the MA. It also provides a security services. Foreign networks, a new network that a MN visits and which is not the home network. Next will be the corresponding node, which is CN, which is also called as a communication partner, that is the node that wants to communicate with the mobile nodes. So at least one partner is needed for communication. So it can be fixed or the mobile node, which is the correspondent node. Next, here we'll be having a pair of address, which is a COA. So C, which is a mobile IP example network. So here we will be having a home network and the corresponding node. The home network and the corresponding node will give to the router. So the corresponding node will give the input to the router, whereas the home network, which gives the input to the router home agent. So both the routers will go to the internet, and via the internet, it will be having a care of address and it sends to the router FA, which is a foreign agent. So with the help of the COA, it goes from router HA to router FA. So from there, it goes to the mobile node, which is a foreign network. So this is what input comes from the home network and the corresponding node to the foreign network. COA means which is a care of address. a new address of MN in a foreign network. So here we'll be having a two different possibilities for the location of COE. Types of COEs are a foreign agent COE and the co-located COE. The foreign agent COE, here we'll be having a static IP address of a foreign agent on a visited network. In co-located COE, the temporary IP address is assigned to the MN, which also represents the current position of the MN on a foreign network, and it can also be used by only one MN at a time. A co-located care of address, that is COE, can be obtained by the dynamic host configuration protocol, which is a DHCP. Next. IP packet delivery, that is how the mobile IP works. So as seen before, we'll be having a correspondent node. So from the correspondent node, we'll be getting into the router, the same as that of the home network to the router home agent. So from the router, it goes to the network. So from the router HA, it goes to the router FA through COA, that is a care of address, which is a second step. From the router FA, it goes to MN, which is the third step. MN, which is a foreign network. So from MN, it again goes to correspondent node. So this is what a packet delivery to and from the mobile nodes. So it is an IP packet delivery, how the mobile IP works. The steps used in the operation of mobile IPs are: step one, the correspondent node sends the packet to the IP address, that is the home address of the mobile nodes. Step two, internet routes the packet to the router of the MN's home network. The home agent examines the packet to find whether the MN is present in its current home networks or not. If the MN is not present, then the HA encapsulates the datagram in a new packet. Step 3. The encapsulated packet is tunneled to the foreign agent, which acts as the new destination address. Then the FA performs a decapsulation to remove the additional headers. Then it will forward the decapsulated packet to the mobile nodes. At last, the step 4, the mobile node, after receiving the packet from the correspondent node, which forwards a relay packet to the correspondent node by specifying its own IP address along with the address of the CN. Next, the key mechanisms in mobile IP, that is a mobile IP operation stages. So here we'll be having three stages. One is the agent discovery, the second one is the registration, the third one will be the tunneling and encapsulation. So see here, we'll be having an internet protocol IP. From that, we'll be, with the help of UDP, that is a user datagram protocol, the registration is done. With the help of the ICMP, that is the internet control message protocol, ICMP, the discovery process is done. At last, the tunneling process. So these are the key mechanisms in the mobile IP: agent discovery, registration, tunneling and encapsulation. First is the agent discovery. A mobile node uses a discovery procedure to identify a prospective home and the foreign agents. The task of the mobile node to determine its foreign agent and the home agent. Both the home agent and the foreign agent periodically broadcast the agent advertisement message. A mobile node must discover a home agent before it leaves to the home network. A mobile node must also discover a foreign agent after it moved to the foreign network. So it uses an ICMP router discovery protocol, which is an IRDP. The ICMP router discovery protocol, that is IRDP, will enable the host to broadcast or multicast to discover the IP address with the help of COA that is a car of address of the neighboring routers, which is called as foreign agent. The agent discovery methods will be having two methods, that is an agent advertisement, agent solicitation. First is the agent advertisement. The functions, it allows the mobile node to find whether an agent is its HA or FA. If it is FA, then it get the COA, that is a care of address. If it allows the mobile node to know the type of service provided by the FA, it also allows the mobile node to know about the allowed registration lifetime or the roaming period of the visiting foreign networks. The ICMP part, see here, we'll be having a type 9, that is type 9, and the port from 0 to 16, and the addresses, that is the number of addresses advertised within this packet. Lifetime means length of the time this advertise is valid. Preferences, the most eager router to get new node. The extension paths are for mobility are the type 16. Length depends on the number of COAs provided with the message. Sequence number, registered lifetime. R means registered. P means PC. H is HA. F means FA. M and G, which is a method of encapsulation. B will be the version. So this is a frame format for agent advertisement packet format. So here the upper part will represent the ICMP, where the lower part will represent the extension packet format. So this is what the agent is covering. Next will be the agent solicitation. So rather than waiting for the agent advertisement, a mobile network can send out an agent solicitation. This solicitation forces any agent on the link to immediately send an agent advertisement. If the mobile node, that is MN, determines that it is connected to the foreign network, then it obtains a COA, which is a care of address. The types of COAs are the foreign agent COA and the co-located COA. The foreign agent COA, here will be having a static IP address of a foreign agent FA on the visited networks. The second type will be the co-located COA, which is a care of address. Here we'll be having a temporary IP address assigned to the mobile node, which represents the current position of the mobile node on the foreign network, and it can be used by only one mobile node at a time. A co-located care of address, it can be obtained by the dynamic host configuration protocol, which is DHCP. The steps for the agent discovery and agent solicitation. First, the mobile agent, that is a HAFA broadcast agent advertisement message at the regular intervals. Second, the mobile node will receive the agent advertisement message, which observes whether the message is from its own HA, and it will determine whether it is on the home network or on the foreign network. After identifying, if the MN does not wish to wait for a periodic advertisement, it can send out the agent solicitation message that will be responded to by the MA. After these steps of advertisements or solicitation, the mobile node can now receive COA, that is a care of address, either one for FA or co-located COA. The mobile node knows its location, that is a home network or a foreign network, and the capabilities of the agents. The next step of MN is the registration with HA if the MN is in the foreign network. Registration. If the MN discovers that it is on the mobile network, that is a home network, then it operates normally without mobile IP. If the mobile node has moved to the new network and it obtains the COA from RFA, then this address will be registered with the HA. Registration, a mobile node uses an authenticated registration procedure to inform the HA of its COA. The registration messages uses UDP protocols. Here, the registration can be done in two different ways. One is registration of the MN through FA, directly with HC. Registration of MN to FA means here we'll be having an MN, FA and HC. From the mobile node, we'll be having a registration request to foreign agent. From the foreign agent, we'll be having a registration request to the HC. From there, we'll be getting a registration reply to the FA, and from there, we'll be getting a registration reply to MN. So if the COA is at FA, means the MN sends its registration request containing COA to FA, which then forward the request to HC. Now the HA will do the mobility binding containing the mobile node, home, IP address and the current COA. Then finally, the HA acknowledgement via FA to the MN. This is for the registration of the MN through FA. It's directly with HA means the MN registration request to HA and we will be getting the registration reply. That is, COA is co-located. The MN sends the request directly to the HA and vice versa. Also, a registration procedure for MN returning to the home network. Registration process. So the registration process involves the exchange of registration records and registration reply messages. When the mobile node registered by using a foreign agent means, the registration process takes place the following steps. So see the diagram, we'll be having a foreign network and the mobile home agent. So inside the home agent, we'll be having a mobility binding table. First, the foreign network. So here we'll be having an IP of MN or IP of HA. From the mobile node, we'll be giving a registration request to the foreign agent. So from there, we'll be getting a registration request to the home agent. So here we'll be updating the mobility binding table. And from there, we'll be getting a registration reply to the foreign agent, that is a visitor list will be updated. From there, a registration reply to the mobile node. So this is what the registration process. So if MN travels to the foreign network, it registers with the FA by sending the registration request message. The FA in turn performs the registration process on behalf of the MN by sending the registration request message to HA. When the HA receives the registration request, it updates the mobility binding table. Then the HA sends the acknowledgement, that is a registration reply, to FA. The FA in turn updates its visitor list and it relays the reply to the mobile node. So this is what the registration request packet transform. So here we'll be having a 0 to 7. So 8 to 15, we'll be having a packet. And from 16 to 23 and from 24 to 31. So this is what the lifetime, home address, home agent, COA, identification, extensions that comes under the registration request packet formats. It's the mobility binding table. So which is maintained on HA of MN. So it maps from MN home address with its current COA. See here we'll be having a home address, COA and the lifetime. For the first home address, we'll be having a care of address and its lifetime in seconds be 200 seconds. For the second one, we'll be having a different care of address and the lifetime will be of 150 seconds. Visitor list, which is maintained on FA, that is foreign agent, which maps the MN home address with its MAC address and HA's address. See here, in visitor list, we'll be having a home address, a home agent address and the media address at last the lifetime in seconds. Tunneling and encapsulation. So tunneling, which is a data transfer. The mechanism used to transfer the IT datagrams from a home address to the care of address, that is sending a packet to the tunnel. A tunnel establishes a virtual pipe for data packets between a tunnel entry and the tunnel entrance. Here we'll be having a two primary functions, that is encapsulation and decapsulation. So the encapsulation means the mechanism of taking a packet consisting of packet header and the data and putting it into the data part of a new part. Here the HA will encapsulate all the packet addresses to MN and forward them to foreign agent. Whereas in the decapsulation, the reverse operation taking a packet out of the data part of the another packet. So here, The FAT encapsulates all the packets addressed to the MN and forward them. So this is a frame format for a tunneling and encapsulations. Next, the steps in encapsulations. When a HA receives a packet address to the MN, it forwards the packet to the COA using IP within IP encapsulation. So using IP or within the IP, the HA inserts a new IP header in front of the IP header of any data class. So here we'll be having a three different ways of performing the encapsulation. That is IP in IP encapsulation, minimal encapsulation, last is the generic routing encapsulation. So IP in IP encapsulation. So this is a mandatory method for mobile IP. The full IP header added to the original IP packets. The inner IP header source and the destination address will identify the original sender and the receivers. The new header contains a HA address as a source and COA as the destination. This is the frame format for IP in IP encapsulations. So here we'll be having a version, next the internet header length, next the DSDOS length, IP identification, flux, fragment offset, TTL, time to lib, IP in IP upper layer protocol, IP checksum, that is an error detection, IP address of the HA, care of address of COA. So these are the frame formats for IP in IP encapsulations. Minimal encapsulation. So it is an optimal method for mobile IP. In IP in IP, several feeds are redundant. Whereas in minimal encapsulation, it will remove these redundancies. Generic routing encapsulation, that is GRE. Here the minimal encapsulation and IP in IP only works for IP, while the generic routing encapsulation also supports other network layer protocols. It also allows the encapsulation of a packet of one protocol suit into the payload option of a packet of another protocol suit. The packet of one protocol suit with the original packet header and the data is taken and the new generic routing encapsulation header is written. So this is the data format for the generic routing encapsulation. So here these are the key authentications. It sets a K bit. If set, it indicates the authentication key is present. Optimizations, that is route optimization. One of the problems with the mobile IP is the triangular routing. So the triangular routing means an inefficient behavior of a non-optimized mobile IP. A triangle is made of three segments. That is correspondent node to home agent, from home agent to COA, that is a care of address or mobile node, from mobile node back to CA. This is a triangular route, which involves two IP routes, which causes unnecessary network traffic overhead and higher latencies. So to optimize the routes, we need to enable the direct notification of the CN. So here the HA will inform a sender about the location of MN. So direct tunneling from the CN to MN. Binding the cache maintained at the CN. Binding cache, which is a part of a local routing table for the CN. The optimized mobile IP protocol needs four additional messages. They are binding request, binding update, binding acknowledgement, binding warning. These are the four additional messages that which is used for optimized IP, mobile IP protocols, binding request. So any node that wants to know the current location of the MN can send the binding request to HA. HA will check if the MN has allowed the broadcasting of its current location. If the HA is allowed to release the location means, it will send back a binding update. Next, the binding update. So this message will send by the HA to CN will reveal the current location of an MN. The message contains the fixed IP address of the MN and the COA. The binding update can request an acknowledgement. So binding acknowledgement means if requested, A node returns this acknowledgement after receiving a binding update message. At last, the binding warning. If a node decouples a packet for a MN, but it is not the current FA for this MN. So this node sends a binding warning to the HA of the MN. Next, reverse tunneling, which is a tunneling from the mobile host to the home agent. And it makes it possible for the mobile host from a foreign network to the communication in the networks. So this is a frame format for the four additional messages for optimized mobile IP protocols. DHCP, which is a dynamic host configuration protocol, which is used to merge the world of mobile phones with the internet and to support the mobility. So it is mainly based on the client-server model. So the client will relay, that is a DHCP discovery, and from the relay it goes to the server, and at last it goes to the client, which is a DHCP discover. So DHCP client sends a request to the server, to which the server responds. The client sends a request using MAC protocols to reach all the devices in the LAN. So the DHCP relay might be needed to forward the request across the interworking units of DHCP server. So this is a frame format. This is a sequence diagram for DHCP. The above figure shows one client and two servers. See, we'll be having a single client that is in the middle, and we'll be having two servers. One is selected and one is non-selected. The client broadcast into the subnet. So the two servers receive this broadcast and find the configuration. Server reply to the client request and offer the configuration parameters. The client can choose only one of the configuration offers. If in turn relies to the server, by accepting one of the configuration and rejecting the others. If the server receives a DHCP rejection, it can feed the reserved configurations. The server with the configuration accepted by the client and confirms the configuration. So that is a DHCP acknowledgement, DHCP release. Next is the MANET, which is a mobile ad hoc network. The types of wireless network are infrastructure. So for the infrastructure, the mobile node can move while communicating. The base station, here the base stations are fixed in infrastructure. As the node goes out of the range of BS, it gets into the range of another BS. So this is the infrastructure network diagram. So infrastructure of the mobile ad hoc. So the MN can move by communicating. So the MANETs are formed dynamically by autonomous systems. So no existing fixed infrastructures. So each node works as a router. So this is an infrastructure ad hoc network or the MANET. So from the PDA, it goes to the pen computer. From that, it laptop computer. From there, it goes to the laptop computer to the PDA. So this is a cycle process. The features of MANET that can be formed without any pre-existing infrastructures. It contains a limited bandwidth and the limited power. Characteristics: lack of fixed infrastructures, dynamic topologies, the bandwidth are constrained, variable capacity links, energy constrained operations, increased vulnerabilities. So these are the characteristics of the MANETs. The challenges, constraints, design issues of MANETs are the limited bandwidth, dynamic topology, routing overhead, hidden terminal problem, packet losses due to transmission errors, mobility induced route changes, battery constraints, security threats. So these are the applications of MANETs. The applications are education, entertainment, sensor networks, context-aware services, coverage extensions, emergency services, tactical networks. So these are the applications which comes under the mobile ad hoc network, which are MANET. Thank you.